Since last year, Supreme Master Qinghai graciously allowed our association members to gather for international seminars. They were joyous occasions as master and disciples reunited to meditate and pray for peace. During her visit to meet with our association members, Supreme Master Qinghai also spoke of the teachings of past masters and answered the spiritual questions of fellow initiates. Throughout the ages, compassionate, enlightened masters have urged people to surrender to the greater universal power by seeking the divine within from which all other goodness and happiness follow. This message was echoed again in Supreme Master Qinghai's discussion with the theme, The Gratitude of a Fox, with our association members in France on January 2, 2009.
台湾台湾台湾举手哦今天都是台湾你们现在外省内省很有那个合作很沟通快一点跳起来了差一点跳起来这样才是人嘛都是中国人嘛何必管他谁做王哪里都好嘛每个人都可以当王的嘞何必争位置嘛争财产什么的等一下走了就没了什么都没有我们中国懂不懂这些哲学啊懂哈懂中文有讲什么还有他们一说讲什么财产都没有那个没有永久那种有没有生不带来死不带去对了对既然都知道不过生的时候还是为了财产而死的困难世界比较难那个时候都知道就做不到所以灾难很多证明多利多不过好像世界越来越好有吗有没有那种感觉有我也是感觉这样不过太慢如果快点多好对啊快点不然我们地球救不了快点大家吃素算怎么不好呢吃素很简单嘛是不是很多蔬菜满地都是一撒几个种子就几天就上来了吃不完何必还要杀生嘛为什么人家不能吃素呢有没有人跟你讲为什么习惯如果没有人杀他就不会习惯了找不到我们的东西我们就吃别的嘛是不是想念你回等一下也会习惯了是不是我也了解了不过生死大事嘛哪里还在那边讲习惯的事情习惯等一下死也没习惯了我们也不会习惯死的因为我们整个辈子没习惯等一下死也不知道去哪里所以我告诉你回去告诉他们要吃素嘛 OK 吃素很简单把那块肉都替代一块豆腐就OK了嘛 豆腐我们中国人做很多是不是最少50种不同的那个口味好厉害是一种艺术做了要知道怎么做不是说普通的而是说普通的豆腐也许简单那种什么 像的豆腐哈，是那种烤的豆腐啊，那些哈，还有豆腐干呢、啊、那些哈，哇，就不容易哦，嗯，不容易，嗯，这么好的东西也不吃可惜哈，还不吃白不吃哈，这真要吃，回去要多卖豆腐广告一下。听说乾隆也吃豆腐呢，很爱豆腐啊！我看电影，看电影他们常常去找那个豆腐脑吃东西啊。习惯当然是对的，不过杀生之祸也要考虑嘛啊！而且我们吃得开心，然后人家痛苦何必嘛啊、哎！第一次动物痛苦不得了，第二是因为我们吃肉那个。别人也痛苦，会饿死，因为那个我们花太多原料，为了要养动物，然后吃了一块肉就不见了，啊，然后多少那个养料啊，都跑到动物那边才能吃，所以别人最少嘛，其实我们习惯也要改。很多人我们喜欢了，很多东西我们喜欢了，不过。我们喜欢跟我们需要不一样啊啊！我们其实生活既然已经说生不带来死不带去的话，何必贪求哈、啊？嗯，吃多等一下也会给虫吃而已啊，也是一米平方而已哈、啊。我们讲一讲，两米最多哈、啊，高的嘛，有钱的就三米吧。不管几米都差不多了哈，哎，那回去多告诉大家哈，尽量吃素啊，这个也是一种保护国家呢，也是一种忠君爱国呢。讲不是说讲那个道德的事情啊，其实我们说中国人都知道忠君爱国有没有？嗯，啊，忠君爱国的话又要吃素嘛，哎，我们吃素全国吃素的话，那个君王也会有福报啊，啊。即使他本身不吃素，整个国家吃素，他也会有福报哎。哎呀，哎，国家福报就是君王的国报，有时候君王的福报也是被染到那个国家呢。所以爱国也是啊，吃素也是一种爱国呢，啊，孝顺呢，啊，我们吃素哈、啊，然后如果父母死了以后没有杀生供养父母那个时日那个和纪念的话。父母升天就不会降下来的，有时候父母已经上去了，就我们杀生了供养他，他也被罚呢，连累啊，连累，不罚多也罚少啊，要看多少那个动物被杀的，哎，所以我们是说也是孝顺呢，哎，然后爱国呢，是说就全国都富有嘛，和平快乐啊。没灾没难啊，没病，没有痛苦，没有饿，啊，每个人都有东西得吃，然后国家和平，啊，安乐，这样是爱国啊。事实上是这样啊，所以吃素包括很多呢啊，孝顺、忠君、爱国，那就大家要赶快吃素吧啊！既然这么好，何必等呢啊？虽然哪个宗教都讲嘛。嗯，要吃素才能够得到福报，不然什么都短暂了，短暂。
Vegetarianism and religion.
The Baha'i Faith.Regarding the eating of animal flesh and abstinence therefrom, know thou of a certainty that in the beginning of creation, God determined the food of every living being, and to eat contrary to that determination is not approved. Selections from the Baha'i Writings on some aspects of health and healing. Buddhism. All meats eaten by living beings are of their own relatives. Lankavatara Sutra.Also, after the birth of the baby, care must be exercised not to kill any animal in order to feed the mother with meaty delicacies, and not to assemble many relatives to drink liquor or to eat meat. Because, at the difficult time of birth, there are innumerable evil demons, monsters, and goblins who want to consume the smelly blood. By ignorantly and adversely resorting to the killing of animals for consumption, they bring down curses upon themselves, which are detrimental to both the mother and the baby. Kasitigarbha Sutra, Chapter 8. Be careful during the days immediately after someone's death, not killing or destroying or creating evil karma by worshipping or offering sacrifice to demons and deities, because such killing and slaughtering committed, or such worship performed, or such sacrifice offered, would not have even an iota of force to benefit the dead, but would entwine even more sinful karma into previous karma, making it even deeper and more serious, thus delay his rebirth to a good state. Karma means retribution. Kasitigarbha Sutra, Chapter 7.
Gaudai, the most important thing is to stop killing, because animals also have souls and understand like humans. If we kill and eat them, then we owe them a blood debt. Teachings of the Saints.
Christianity, meats for the belly and the belly for meats, but God shall destroy both it and them. Holy Bible.
And while the flesh was yet between their teeth, ere it was chewed, the wrath of the Lord was kindled against the people, and the Lord smote the people with a very great plague. Holy Bible.
Confucianism. All men have a mind which cannot bear to see the sufferings of others. The superior man, having seen the animals alive, cannot bear to see them die. Having heard their dying cries, he cannot bear to eat their flesh. Mencius. Essenes. I am come to end the sacrifices and feasts of blood, and if ye cease not offering and eating of flesh and blood, the wrath of God shall not cease from you. Gospel of the Holy Twelve.
Hinduism.
Since you cannot bring killed animals back to life, you are responsible for killing them. Therefore, you are going to hell. There is no way for your deliverance. Adilila.
He who desires to augment his own flesh by eating the flesh of other creatures lives in misery in whatever species he may take his birth. Mahabharata anew.
Islam. Allah will not give mercy to anyone except those who give mercy to other creatures. Hadith.
Do not allow your stomachs to become graveyards of animals. Hadith.
Jainism. A true monk should not accept such food and drink as has been specially prepared for him involving the slaughter of living beings. Sutrakatanga.
Judaism. And whatsoever man there be of the house of Israel, or of the strangers that sojourn among you, that eateth any manner of blood, I will even set my face against that soul that eateth blood, and will cut him off from among his people. Holy Bible. Blood, meaning flesh.
Sikhism. Those mortals who consume marijuana, flesh, and wine, no matter what pilgrimages, fasts, and rituals they follow, they will all go to hell. Guru Granth Sahib.
Taoism. Do not go into the mountain to catch birds and nets, nor to the water to poison fishes and minnows. Do not butcher the ox that plows your field. Tract of the Quiet Way.
Tibetan Buddhism. The offering to the deities of meat obtained by killing animate beings is like offering a mother the flesh of her own child, and this is a grievous failure, the supreme path of discipleship.
Zoroastrianism. Those plants, I, Ahura Mazda, or God, rain down upon the earth to bring food to the faithful and fodder to the beneficent cow, Avesta.
Everybody knows that vegetarian diet is good for health and to save the planet. They will be awakening their own great, compassionate, loving self-nature, and then their level of consciousness will rise up automatically, and they will understand more than they ever did, and they'll be closer to heaven than what they are right now. Okay, this story is about freeing a fox. Yeah. And the person has earned some very good merit, so he avoided some big, big disaster. Yeah. There is one kind of tree. This kind of tree is about 3 meters high, and the leaves are like needle. And the flower, it looked like the upside-down bell. And the fruit is like a black bean, big black bean. It is said that this kind of tree, if you drink the essence of the plant, then you will live a long, long time. there was a monk, Buddhist monk. His appearance is very, very rough and not good looking. Not very good looking. And his spiritual practice is also not so much. His name was Liao Kong. Liao Kong means he understands the emptiness, yeah, less hope. It's a name like that, okay. He had heard that this kind of tree can help you to live long, long time. So he wanted to experiment it to see if it's true or not. So he plucked some leaves from the tree, so some fruits, and then he threw them into a well with water. Yes. And then he went out and told those, countryside folks, you know, the one who don't understand much about things. He told them, okay, you know what? Anyone who can go down to the well and smell this plant called gold essence will live very long time. You will not be old. You will live forever. Among these country folks, you know, simple country folk, there was a person, we call him Tang Adam. His name is like that. He believed the monk. So he climbed out into the well. Oh my God. After he went down the well, the monk covered the well. He wanted to experiment whether or not this kind of plant will make you live forever in any situation. Luckily, they warned us beforehand that this monk is a very bad and he did not practice very well. You know, he did not have good character, did not have a real monk quality. So, Tang Adam, he did not know what else to do. So he only sit there and wait for death. And thinking like that, he was crying, and cursing the monk, yeah? That what kind of cruel monk, kind of a loveless and compassionless and terrible monk. You know, he was cursing him like, you're wearing a monk robe, but you have a heart of the devil, something like that, you know? And you are going to have nothing good in your life. That's what he said. He was cursing the monk. Of course, now in this situation, you can understand him, no? Yeah. All right. He was sitting there until twilight. And then suddenly the monk left. The monk's gone. And suddenly there was a fox that came next to the mouth of the well, you know, above the earth. And the fox talked in human language. He said to the person down the well, he said, fear not. I am the immortal fox, yes, who has been practicing Zen for a long time. There are such fox. Yes, truly. That's why we should never harm any animals, because you never know what is what. Yeah. I told you animals also have soul, and they understand everything. They can also practice, yes? They might not be maybe a saintly person who go out preaching and things like that, but they can practice to liberate themselves out of the three world, or at least they come to the third level. Even the wild birds and animals outside, many of them are high level.
It is a joy to have you with us today for Between Master and Disciples. Please join us again tomorrow for part two of Supreme Master Ching Hai's discussion, The Gratitude of a Fox. Healthy Living is up next on Supreme Master Television, right after Noteworthy News. Please stay tuned. Heaven's blessings to you and your loved ones for evermore peace and happiness.
For more details, please visit www.suprememastertv.com/BMD